was wearing size testy pants. So we go way back. I remember when I was in high school, I went to Page High School, and we were the first class, 1971. That's when Greensboro integrated all the students. And so I graduated in 1974, so we were the first class, you know, to graduate for 4 or 3 years for integration. But anyway, I remember when I was in high school, the 12th grade, you know, I was a real shy guy. You know, very shy, kind of introvert. And I was at this park with my best friend, Larry. And I saw this girl, and she was fine, you know, and I was like, wow, Larry, I want to talk to her, man, but I'm scared. And he said, hey, look here, Shaw, man. You know, they just call me Shaw, man. That just made me feel like a superhero, you know. And it's kind of like, you know, he can jump up a sidewalk crack in a single bound. You know, he's stronger than the mightiest man. And he has X-ray vision stuff. He can look under girls' dresses and stuff like that. But anyway, Larry told me that, well, look, Shaw, man, that's all you got to do. You know, just go up to the girl and just say, like, boom, my name is Michael Shaw. And so I took his advice, and I went up to the girl's door and knocked on it. And lucky for me, she answered the door. And she opened the door, and I said, like, boom, my name is Michael Shaw. And she smiled and closed the door in my face, you know. And so after that, I started trying to write down my own little raps and stuff. In 1974, I joined the Army. And I got stationed at Fort Bragg. And I was, back then we had 8 men in a bed. You know, it's 8 men in a room if you were private. And I happened to have a roommate who was a Vietnam veteran. Okay? And he had a little hard luck. And he came back on active duty, and he was late 30s to maybe 40. And he would have these flashbacks. And, you know, and the thing about the guy, he was a real dark brother. You know, he was darker than blue. And it's kind of like, if you ever watch the National Geographic Channel, you see the Sudan people, you know, they have this hue of blue in them. But he was real dark like that. And he looked like a damn gorilla. And his name was Calloway. And I remember one day we were sitting in the day room. That's where we shoot pool and stuff. We have a foosball table and TV, beer machine, Coke machine. And he was sitting on top of one of the pool tables. And he had a sip of rum, and he was taking a swig in it. And he started thinking about something. He was in the 173rd Airborne. And this unit has a lot of history, you know, good history. And he started thinking about being back in Vietnam. And he started telling us, he said, yeah, we are out in the bush. And the lieutenant said, hey, Calloway, come go with me. We're gonna take point. He said, I ain't going up there. He said, well, I'm a court-martial, Calloway. Court-martial me, because I'm not going out there. And so that's the kind of guy it was. When I was in the Army, we had some songs. And I don't think they could sing these kind of slim songs today with people, especially with females. When you're in combat arms,